Hey guys, at Catfish Pond in Martinsville, Virginia. It's relatively close to the house and it's a lot of technical stuff. It's a little muddy for my taste, but still somewhere to ride. But we got the KRX back on stocks just to play a little bit. And then we've got the RMAX that this good looking man right here drives, Jerry. He's not single, ladies, I'm sorry. But all right, we'll hit the trail.
Well, when I had a T-Race, I just had a back one.
Thank you.
All right, so y'all seen the other video getting here, most of it anyway. This is the lookout point at Catfish. It's just kind of a power line, and the trail actually goes down there and loops back over, and that's the technical loop. That's what we'll do next. This is one of the harder climbs on the power line trail at Catfish. The RMAX coming up. Oh yeah, there you go. Look at that. Walked it. Video, this looks like absolutely nothing as usual, but this is very steep and very, very slick. I think the wheelbase of the RMAX is going to help out, especially if he stays up on that wall. Oh yeah, oh look at that. Try to bump it. There he goes. Oh yeah. Hey, try to back up and get back on the wall. I think
wheelbase might have actually hurt him a little bit.
Try to get up on it. Yeah, try to get up on it high and put your tire right beside that stump. There you go. Beautiful, beautiful. It's all about line choice, fellas.
Thank you.
carry on the RMAX. I know on video this looks like garbage, guys, but this is actually really tough and slick, and it's half ice, the other half's red mud, which is slicker than eel snot, which you you East Coast guys will know what I'm talking about. There he goes, in the rut. right, guys, this is the V-notch. Video makes it look like nothing, but it's like five, six feet deep. He's going to have to over-exaggerate it uphill to stay in the rut. We'll see if the RMAX's width allows him to do that. Oh no. You gotta over-exaggerate it. Back up and get back higher on the hill. No, you were way too far that way.
My right tire was gonna fall in it.
No, you're not. I'll let you know if it is. Put your tire way up the hill. I don't know if you got the width. I don't know if you got the width or not.
Yeah, I know. It keeps sliding down.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't go any farther. I'd try this line over here.
Is there another way?
Yeah, yeah. Just back down and then come up that one, and I'll get you. I'll come. I'll video you
was
coming up
not
that.
Over far enough?
Nah. You got to go way up it.
Well, how far was my right tire from going in it?
Probably like a foot.
Huh?
Probably like a foot.
Oh, so I can go more this way?
Yeah. If you want to try it, I mean, I'll video it. Oh, Yamaha. But hey, look at the bright side. A Polaris will be broken right now. It would have broke the front diff, both axles. It would have caught on fire. And then probably had a recall by the time he made it up the hill. Yeah, I just don't think you got the width. All right, the Yamaha apparently is not going to be denied. There you go. It's just like that much too narrow. Yeah. You gave it a shot. All right, guys, so the Yamaha had to back down. He tried it three or four times, but it just doesn't have the width. I mean, that's kind of what you got to deal with a 64 versus a 68 and a half, like the KRX. I mean, he was right there, but it just wasn't quite wide enough. Maybe some offset wheels or something, but then it's going to make it handle bad. But, I mean, that's the difference, guys. That's what we want you to see in this video, is that 64 and 68 are different beasts. So, it's just as capable. It just doesn't have the width.
Gotta put my tire on that log. Don't put it out until we get past this tree.
Camera.